Egerns are creatures better known to most as giant centipedes, as the real name of this creature was said to be too hard to pronounce when in danger. Scolopendromorph, in case you wondered. You might recognize them from the games, as they appear in both The Witcher 1 and in The Witcher 3 Blood and Wine. However, the first appearance of this creature was in the books, right at the moment when Geralt first met Ciri. A small creature in a short grey jacket was standing in a small clearing, at the foot of a rocky cliff, with its back pressing against the trunk of a withered hornbeam. Something was moving slowly about, 5 paces in front of it, parting the grass. That thing was about 12 feet long and was dark brown. At first, Geralt thought it was a snake, but then he noticed the wiggling, yellow, hooked limbs, and flat segments of the long thorax, and realized it was not a snake. It was something much more sinister. The creature hugging the tree cried out shrilly. The immense myriapod raised above the grass, long twitching feelers with which it sensed odors and warmth. "Don't move!" The Witcher yelled and stamped to attract the Scolopendromorph's attention, but the myriapod did not react, for its feelers had already caught scent of its nearer victim. The monster wiggled its limbs, coiled itself up like an S, and moved forward. Its bright yellow limbs rippled through the grass, evenly like the oars of a galley. "Egern!" Bren yelled. Geralt hurtled into the clearing in 2 bounds, jerking his sword from the scabbard on his back as he ran, and in full flight struck the petrified creature beneath the tree with his hip, shoving it aside into some brambles. The Scolopendromorph rustled the grass, wiggling its legs and tacked, raising its anterior segments, its venom-dripping pincers shattering. Geralt danced, leaped over the flat body, and slashed it with a sword from half a turn, aiming at the vulnerable spots between the armored plates on its body. The monster was too swift, however, and the sword struck the chitinous shells, without cutting it through it. The thick carpet of moss absorbed the blow. Geralt dodged, but not deftly enough. The Scolopendromorph wound the posterior part of its body around its legs with enormous strength. The Witcher fell, rolled over, and tried to pull himself free, in vain. The myriapod flexed and turned around to reach him with its pincers, at the same time fiercely dug its claws into the tree and wrapped itself around it. Right then, an arrow hissed above Geralt's head, penetrating the armor with a crack, pinning the creature to the trunk. The Scolopendromorph writhed, broke the arrow and freed itself, but it was struck by 2 more. The Witcher kicked the threshing abdomen off and rolled away to the side. Bran, kneeling, was shooting at an astonishing rate, sending arrow after arrow at the Scolopendromorph. The myriapod was breaking the shafts to free itself, but each successive arrow would pin it at the trunk again. The creature snapped its flat, shiny dark red maw and clanked its pincers by the places which had been pierced by the arrows, instinctively trying to reach the enemy which was wounding it. Geralt leaped at it from the side, took a big swing, and hacked with his sword, ending the fight with 1 blow. The tree acted like an executioner's block. Bran approached slowly. An arrow knocked, kicked the body, writhing in the grass, its limbs thrashing around, and spat on it. "Thanks," the Witcher said, crushing the beast's severed head with 1 blow of his heel. "Eh? You saved my life." If it wasn't for Bran, the Witcher saga would have ended very quickly, and without much spectacle, as this creature would have been able to kill both Geralt and Ciri. These creatures are tough opponents, even for Witchers. Their armored plating is almost resistant to blades and cuts, making it very hard to harm them. But where do these creatures come from? There are a few locations that I know that they have been seen, those being Brocolon, Temeria, Ophir, Dobrathana, and Toussaint. Some common folk, however, believe that dryads breed these creatures and release them into the world when fully grown. This, however, is nonsense. About the same level of nonsense that the belief is that they split up into 2 creatures if cut in half. These Egerns have the habit of living nearby Shalmars, as they eat the creatures that eat the Shalmar's droppings, which provide the centipedes with a source of food. There are several subspecies of these centipedes, most notably the V, Pale Widows, and Myriapodons. These were created using magic, and were a lot larger than the Egons. One of them was said to have destroyed the elven city upon which Maribor was built. Pale Widows, on the other hand, looked and acted pretty much the same as the normal Egons. Their main difference, as you might have guessed, is that they were pale white instead of brown. The last subtype of these creatures was the Myriapodon. It was mentioned by Dandelion to live nearby Lower Posada. If you were to face off against these creatures in The Witcher 3, there are a few things you have to keep in mind. These centipedes are active diggers, and will spend a lot of time trying to knock you back by jumping from the ground right below you. If you put down a well-timed Eden, you can stun the creature in its place, allowing you to get a good few hits off on the soft parts of its body. It's important to keep moving, as besides trying to hit you with its mandibles, it will also spit acid at you, giving it an ability to steal the damage over distances. You can protect yourself with Quen, or to prevent getting hit by the spit, you can just jump away. If you manage to get a few hits in on these creatures, they will curl up, only exposing the hard outer shell of their body. Hitting them doesn't do much while in the state. Instead, quickly dodge away, as they will unwind and try to hit you with their spinning body, slamming you back. These creatures are very dangerous, and can be a threat to even the experienced witchers. Best of luck hunting these creatures down. Try not to get caught by the many legs, or it will be your last hunt. As one last clarification, Egern is the elven word for the giant centipede. That was it. Till next video. Bye.